Hello everyone, myself Dr. M. Srujan Kumar. My education background is pharmacy. Today's topic is medicated bandages. Before knowing about medicated bandages, one has to know what do you mean by the term bandages and what are the different types of bandages available in the market and how these bandages have been classified according to their source material. In order to know all these things, please subscribe to my channel and go through a video called as surgical dressings. Medicated bandages comes under the category of surgical dressings. Yeah, let us move on to the topic. So, before knowing medicated bandages, first we will define what do you mean by the term bandage. A bandage is a piece of material used. What is the purpose of bandage? It is used either to support a medical device such as dressing or splint. Okay, bandage will help you to support dressing or splint. It not only provides support, it also helps you to restrict the movement of part of the body. When used with a dressing, if you are applying bandage along with the dressing, what is the purpose of bandage here? So dressing will be applied to the wound. Okay, in order to hold the dressing adhered to the wound, you are going to apply bandage onto the dressing. Other bandages, there are bandages which hold only dressing, but there are some other bandages that are used without dressings also. Such as, the examples for such bandages are elastic bandages that are used to reduce swelling or provide support to a sprained ankle. Okay, there are some elastic bandages. The purpose of elastic bandage is to reduce swelling or to provide support to a sprained ankle. There are some other bandages like tight bandages. They can be used to slow blood flow to an extremity, such as when a leg or arm is bleeding heavily. A condition where a leg or arm is heavily bleeding. So in order to slow down the blood flow, you can use tight bandages onto the affected area. Okay, so here comes your medicated bandages. What are medicated bandages? What is the difference between a bandage and medicated bandage? Here in the name itself, we can say that a bandage will be there, a plain bandage. To that, some medicament will be fabricated onto the normal bandage. A medicament fabricated onto the normal bandage is called as a medicated bandages. That means we can say that medicated bandages will possess some sort of pharmacological action. Okay, so these medicated bandages are used in the treatment of chronic eczema or dermatitis where occlusion is indicated. Now we need to know about this terminology called as chronic eczema, dermatitis and occlusion. What do you mean by this? So eczema is a condition. Eczema is a condition where patches of skin become inflamed, itchy, red, crackled and rough. What do you mean by the term eczema? Eczema is a condition where patches of skin become inflamed, itchy, red, cracked and rough. Okay. So the word eczema is also used specifically to talk about atopic dermatitis. The word eczema is also used specifically to talk about atopic dermatitis. Okay, what do you mean by occlusion here? Occlusion is nothing but the blockage or closing of blood vessel or hollow organ. Occlusion is nothing but blockage or closing of blood vessel or hollow organ. So on a whole, medicated bandages are used in the treatment of chronic eczema. When you say chronic, so always the disease conditions move from acute to chronic. So these medicated bandages are intended for the treatment of chronic eczema or dermatitis where occlusion is indicated. Occlusion is nothing but blockage or closing of blood vessel or hollow organ. Yeah. Now we will move on to the information on marketed medicated bandages. Okay, we'll move on to the information of marketed medicated. What are all the medicated bandages that are present in the market? It is very important to know what is its brand name, what are the composition of that marketed medicated bandage and what are the applications or indications of that medicated bandages. Yeah, we'll go one by one. The first medicated bandage is Calaband. The name of the medicated bandage is Calaband. It's a brand name. Okay, the product name is Calaband. Okay, when you see with the composition, okay, the generic name, it is zinc paste and calamine bandage. The generic name is zinc paste and calamine bandage. The brand name is Calaband. The composition of this Calaband is zinc oxide, calamine, modified starch, citric acid, glycerin, castor oil, phenocept and water. The composition of zinc paste and calamine bandage is zinc oxide, calamine, modified starch, citric acid, glycerin, castor oil, phenocept and water. Okay, so coming to the indications of this Calaband. Calaband is indicated in the treatment of chronic eczema and dermatitis where occlusion is indicated, as I explained about the terminology is called as eczema or dermatitis, and it also used in the treatment as an adjunct to compression therapy, as an adjunct to compression therapy for the management of venous and gravitational ulcers. It is also used as an adjunct to compression therapy for the management of venous and gravitational ulcers. Now coming to what do you mean by compression therapy, that we need to know. Okay, compression therapy is a simple and effective means of increasing blood flow activity in the lower limbs through strengthening vein support. What do you mean by compression therapy? It is nothing but a simple and effective means of increasing blood flow activity in the lower limbs through strengthening vein support. It's a form of wound care, okay, that aims to gently apply pressure to the ankles and legs by wearing specifically designed stockings. Okay, it is a form of wound care that aim to gently apply pressure to the ankles and legs by wearing specifically designed stockings. Okay, it not only indicated in the treatment of your chronic eczema and dermatitis, it also acts as an adjunct to compression therapy. Already the patient has been undergoing compression therapy. Okay, so as a supplementary to that, you can have this Calaband also. So this compression therapy mainly indicated in the management of venous and gravitational ulcers. In the management of venous and gravitational ulcers. What are these gravitational ulcers? The term gravitational ulcers means an ulcer of the leg that is caused by an abnormality of the venous return of blood from the leg. What do you mean by gravitational ulcer? It means an ulcer of the leg that is caused by an abnormality of the venous return of blood from the leg. Such a condition is found in association with varicose veins. This particular condition will be found associated with varicose veins. Okay, in that particular conditions also you can use Calaband as an adjunct. Okay, adjunct means nothing but supplementary to the compression therapy. Okay, yeah. This is about your Calaband. Now coming to Iktaband. Iktaband. The next band is Iktaband. So here the product name is Iktaband. It's a brand name. And the generic name of your Iktaband is Bandage Zinc Paste and Iktamol. Bandage Zinc Paste and Iktamol. Coming to the composition of Iktaband. It contains zinc oxide, Iktamol, modified starch, glycerin, castor oil, citric acid, propyl hydroxybenzoate and water. Propyl hydroxybenzoate and water. Now coming to the indications of Iktaband, it is used in the treatment of subacute enzematous condition, subacute eczematic condition, chronic eczema, not only used in the treatment of your eczematous conditions like chronic eczema, it is also acts as a protective barrier for thin and fragile skin. It acts as a protective barrier for thin and fragile skin. Okay, these are the indications of your ICTA band. Moving on to the Clinaband. The product name is Clinaband. And your generic name is Band-Aid Zinc Paste Calamine and Clioquinol. Okay, coming to the composition. The main ingredients are your zinc oxide, clioquinol, calamine. These are your main ingredients, followed by your excipients, modified starch, citric acid, glycerin, castor oil, TPOL, phenoxyethanol, water. Now, indications. Indications of your Clinaband. It is used in the treatment of venous and gravitational ulcers. As an adjunct to compression therapy. Okay. Adjunct is nothing but supplementary to compression therapy. It is in the treatment of venous and gravitational ulcers. Already for venous and gravitational ulcers, there is a therapy called as compression therapy. To adjunct to, for supplementary to your compression therapy, you are giving something called as Clinaband. Okay. Next. Viscopaste PB7. Product name is Viscopaste PB7. Generic name, Band-Aid Zinc Paste. The main ingredient, zinc oxide with glycerol, followed by cetostearyl alcohol, ketomacrogol, white oil, guar gum, xanthan gum, methyl p hydroxybenzoate, propyl p hydroxybenzoate, and purified water. This constitutes your composition of Viscopaste PB7. Okay, coming to the indications, adjunct to compression therapy in the management of leg ulcers. It is also used in the treatment of chronic eczema or dermatitis where occlusion is indicated. Clear? Thank you very much for your patience. Please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Thank you very much.